Nothing worse than a four-fold jump off.
Come on, Ronnie.
Yes, yes, Ronnie.
Come on. Ronnie Healy, the winner of the 2023 United Aviation Group South African Derby.
Of it. I mean, Jonathan, Tracy, Bronwyn and Dominey at this stage that are all sitting on eight faults. So, one stride off the bank. I haven't seen that before. Oh,
wowza.
Okay, now she's going to have to just regroup a little bit there. Come on, Lexington. Sure, very, very good jump.
Wow.
Okay, three from home. Let's see if she can keep it on the four. This will definitely put her into the lead. Everyone sitting here next to us on their feet. Sorry, standing here next to us on their feet. Come on, John.
Oh.
Come on, Lexington.
Four, five, six, seven.
Yes,
yes,
John.
Yo. Incredible riding.
What a round. Standing ovation out here. Good job.
Excellent riding, what a horse.
Oh, the smile says it all.
Four riders on eight penalties. We have one rider on four faults. We have no clears in the South African United Aviation Group Derby 2023 with the top qualifier who's last to go. So unfortunately,
Ronnie Healy, it's all up to you.
All up to you. I mean, you got to, I mean, I suppose he's got to jump a clear round, which could win it, or take Jean to a four-fold jump off. I don't think that he'd want to do that. He knows how fast Lexington is. So the pressure's on. This was previously owned by the late Ronnie Lawrence.
Yep, safely over that plank.
Eyes up, Ron. Right, you want to really set the horse up for this. Make sure that he understands where he's going.
Give him space jumping out.
The people in the crowd are jumping
on,
every
Ronnie.
Single jump with him. It's incredible to watch. Everybody's knees are going. Come on, Ron. On the seven. I can barely walk. He'd want a good shot at the water. He's a little off. The horse jumps it clean.
Beautiful jump over the wall.
All right.
Okay, he's got to turn back to this last line. Keep it together, boys.
You'd really, really want a good shot here. You want a good up jump with a really good body here. Shoulders. Come on, Ron.
One to go. Nothing worse than a four-fold jump off.
Come on, Ron.
Yes,
yes, Ronnie.
Come on.
Come on!
And
there you have it, ladies and gentlemen.
Goes wild.
Ronnie Healy, the winner of the 2023 United Aviation Group South African Derby. Take a bow, bud. What a pressure round. Man, that was incredible. Oh man, what a round.
You see there his support team.
There's Andre and Ashley all there giving him a big hug. I mean, now we can give him a little go. He's going to be super emotional after this.
The dust has settled. 2 days into your reign as 2023 United Aviation Derby champion. It sounds good. How does it feel?
As good as it sounds. A lifelong dream. A friend of mine on Sunday sent me a message, Justin Hawkins, saying we were at the original Ananda in Sandton all those years ago, watching Barry and Ronnie win on Panache and I think it was Avalanche. And we dreamed of winning the Derby. And he said, your dream has come true. I think every show jumper wants to win the Derby more than anything else. That's for sure me. The one that I've wanted, the one that I hoped. You know, I've jumped Hickstead, Hamburg. You just want to win one of these big, prestigious Derbies.
Well, funny enough, you know, I said to Dominic Alexander when I interviewed him about 3 or 4 months ago, I said to him, you know, South Africa's greatest champion jockey ever, Michael Roberts, toiled his whole life to win the Rothmans July. That was the crowning glory of everything. And eventually in 1997, after 35 years of riding, he succeeds. And it must have been a similar sort of situation to Domini, who came up one of the first guys to congratulate champion to champion.
Yeah, it was very special. I mean, Dom trained with him for a while and, you know, just through circumstances of life, Ash and I were so busy with our new business and kids, we had to get someone to come to us, and you know, that's where I went back to Ron. There was no hard feelings, but he was the first one up there. We were, you know, we're great friends, and it was very special, you know. And then on Monday morning, he sent me a message early, you know, saying well done, you rode so beautifully, and I sent him a video of my youngest son Hudson screaming at Ash and I, and he's like, welcome to parenthood, my boy. And you know, our friendship has, you know, always been so special like that. It was really cool watching him win it last year. It meant the world to him, and when you go through that finish, I will forever have that memory ingrained in me, and it's something special. Now I want to try and win another, you know, and I think that's going to be the next hurdle and the next excitement, but I've won one. So it's you know, that personal pressure's, you know, sort of been taken away.
Well, you know, when you look at those magnificent grandstands and you see the names of Gonda Butters and Annalie Vogelfenning and Barry Taylor, Gail Foxcroft, I mean, they've won 3, 4. And yet, funny enough, Nicole Horwood, who's won 4, hasn't got a name. They've run out of grandstands for her.
They need to make her own grandstand. I mean, if that's not enough to push you on, then I don't know what is. Definitely Nicole Horwood needs one. That is for sure. I mean, she's the Derby queen, you know, behind Gonda. And Gonda was inspirational with those 6 Derby titles, you know. And she now coaches my wife, Ash, and myself. And she's now, I'm her 10th pupil to win the Derby. So that's something on its own. To win it 6 times and then to train 10 separate individuals. Yeah. She's just, I've only been training her, you know, since Ronnie's passing, and she is something else. You know, 80 years young, and is more passionate than I've ever experienced, you know, and it gives me more passion in my coaching and my riding. But, you know, that's what we work towards, you know, those goals.
You've got to have an iconic figure like her, like Mickey Lowe, or one of the greats.
Yeah, I mean, obviously I trained most of my life with Ronnie, you know, so that was, you know, who I always looked up to. And obviously I know Gonda and what she's won, and there's nothing she hasn't won. So how many times she's won it, you know, and now through training with her, I can see why. Her attention to detail is second to none. And she's taken my riding to another level. Whenever I get on the horse, I can win anything. I just feel like very privileged to have this time with her.
Funny enough, you know, on the Saturday evening, I was filling up at the mobile garage in Lone Hill. And who comes along but Gonda? And she's talking to the petrol attendant. And I said, do you know who you're talking? You're talking to the Nelson Mandela of show jumping, the Gary Player of show jumping. I mean, she just is such an incredible inspiration, and still so down to earth.
Yeah, she is an incredible person. You know, we had her birthday recently, and she had this cake, and then our boys wanted Gonda's birthday cake. I mean, I have a 1.5-year-old and a 2.5, and she was like, brilliant, and she put a little piece of cake in, well, it wasn't little, it was a massive piece of cake in this box, and she made such an effort for me to get it. And then Fomi was like, did they enjoy it? And hopefully you didn't give it all to them. You
know? Bouncing off the walls.
Yeah, they're bouncing off the walls. And it's just so special. Like, I've just clicked with her, and I'm loving my time with Gonda as a pupil and building a friendship. You know, it's very special.
Okay, so this particular chapter, and I hope there are going to be many more of them, is anywhere but complete without the sheer history and beauty of this derby.
Sure, gives me goosebumps just thinking about it. But Ronnie, when he took a turn for the worse at the beginning of the year, asked me to ride Gillian, Goofy. And there isn't one person doesn't love that horse. And I was like, Ron, that's an honor that you asked me to ride your horse. You know, he said, you know, keep him here. Is yours, and it was the biggest sign of respect between two humans. I think he gave me, and I would give to him, and wasn't all rosy when it started. I think I struggled to adapt to the horse. You know, it's been with one person for most of his whole life. You know, Goofy's only been ridden by Ronnie, and Ronnie's a master. I was a master, and it's taken time for me to adapt to him. You know, I think when Gonda really came on and helped me out, like, she changed my thinking a lot of how I rode to how I'm riding. And it's helped that horse massively, and me, you know, to gel. At one point I said to Ash, I don't think I'm doing this horse justice, and I must give it to someone else that will do better. I don't want the horse to suffer, you know. So there was a show, it was the World Cup at Kailami, and I jumped around the World Cup, and I had a couple down, but I felt something like, I can see where I'm got to go with this now. I'm just so privileged to have. He is the nicest person in that horse. You know, like, you get really nice horses that you love dealing. He is just, I would put, like my little boy hangs around him, and he's pricks his ears like he sees Andre, and his ears prick, and he cuddles Andre, and, you know, and he's like, and I see him now, and he nickers a little bit at me, and like, he's just, the people that, like, he knows are like, he's just the happiest horse. And he was so proud of himself on Sunday, you know.
I could see that, because it doesn't matter who won, there was always going to be a celebration if Jean won or any of the others won, but it all seemed to come together. Because the faces around you, and the sheer unbridled joy and passion surrounding that horse, and the way he accepted it, it was indescribably beautiful.
Yeah, I think that's what made... I've had a lot of phone calls and messages, and most... I mean, I'm always emotional. My wife always says, stop crying, you know. And I am. I wear my heart on my sleeve, and I just burst into tears going through the finish. You know, it was, yeah.
Many things going through your mind, thinking about Ronnie, thinking about the horse, thinking about your dream come to fruition.
Yeah, I didn't say this. I mean, Andre knew, but And my last, one of my last conversations with Ronnie when he was lying down and was just sitting and talking, and I said to him, Ron, I'm going to win you the derby this year. You know. So it was emotional. It was. My life is very different now than it used to be. I mean, obviously my boys are everything to Ash and I, and if I'm not here at the stables riding or teaching, I try and spend as much time with them. You know, it's I think also put a lot of perspective into my life when they came along. I said to myself on Sunday morning, you know, trying to just keep everything calm. I said to myself, your boys are still going to love you, you know, no matter what happens. And that was enough for me, you know, and then just go and do your job. You know, we've been working hard for this and I wasn't letting this one go. You know, I was going to make sure that I made it count. So, you know, it was Ronnie's, you know, dream to win it on that horse. My dream to win it, you know, and it was just all worked out that it was on that horse. So, very special.
So I say,